call for reinforcement.
Following the presidential age limit judgment last week, disgruntled sections of the public have since vowed to petition the ruling. Lawyer Malema Bidizi was the first to take the bold step in his appeal to the Supreme Court, where he outlined 80 issues on which he challenged sections of the ruling. Today, six legislators, among them Gerald Karuhanga, Odoo Jonathan, Mubarak Mnyagwa, Alan Sewanyana, Ibrahim Semujunganda, and Winfred Kiza, have also filed a notice of appeal challenging the age limit judgment. These are represented by city lawyers Lodislas Rakafuzi and Elias Lukwago from Lukwago and Company Advocates.
We talk right now, it is before the registrar, and the copies are going to be given to you. So we have filed a notice of appeal with 11 broad areas of contention. From these broad areas, we are going to generate grounds of appeal. The grounds of appeal are supposed to be contained in the memorandum of appeal. That is the next step. We have also written to the registrar to avail us a copy of the record of proceedings, the entire record, to any bus prepare the memorandum of appeal and also proceed with the appeal. Because for us to prosecute this appeal, we must have the entire record.
We also argued that the constitution was also amended illegally through bribery. That is also contrary to Article 3, Clause 2 of the Constitution, which says other unlawful means of amending the Constitution. We think, Justice Kakuru found, that the giving of 29 million shillings amounted to a bribe. So the Constitution was amended through bribery.
The petitioners have outlined 11 issues expressing dissatisfaction with part of the decisions and orders made by the judges during the court ruling. They are, however, majorly concerned by the fact that court did not summon the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, the Finance Minister, Matia Kasaija, Rafael Majezi, the mover of the age limit bill, and President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni.
The President himself, who assented to the bill with a defective certificate, and who also features prominently in this bill, and actually I'm not shy to say, the sole beneficiary of this bill or the Constitutional Amendment Act, was never someone to come and testify.
They also asked the Attorney General to give a response on the President's reaction towards the court ruling. The President is said to have criticized judges of the Constitutional Court for nullifying the extension of the term of Parliament from 5 to 7 years and described their decision as an undemocratic age limit nonsense. This report was filed by Jaliat Namwaya for Urban TV.